Hello. This is Everett Bug with a warning about Raid House and Garden Bug Killer. A menace to all peace-loving bugs, indoors and out. Raid hunts bugs down like radar and kills them dead.
Raid, Glade, Off, Pledge, and Windex are some of the world's most trusted and beloved household products that scientists created here at the Research Tower.
Rising above the bustling city of Racine, Wisconsin, the latest addition to an industrial plant that's already one of the most advanced anywhere. The new research laboratory, Johnson's Wax, is a tower of glass built on a column that penetrates deep into the ground, supporting the building just as a tree supports its branches. The 15-story structure is built around a hollow, reinforced core, which contains all essential services, such as elevators, plumbing, power, and telephone lines. Johnson first pioneered in the field of industrial architecture more than a decade ago with this Frank Lloyd Wright administration building. The bright, cheerful atmosphere of the place met with immediate and continuing enthusiasm, helping to account for high employee morale. Here, too, interior supports carry the weight of the building, allowing the exterior walls to be largely glass. The decorative pattern of all offices fits in with the architectural theme. Oval desks and tables accent the sweeping curves of the walls. Even drawers are circular. Now let's follow along as the young lady delivers those papers. From the ground floor of the administration building, she takes a glass-enclosed elevator to the second floor. Beneath a ceiling of glass tubing, she walks in daylight down a corridor that connects the administration building with the tower that houses the research lab. We step out into one of the most modern scientific workrooms to be found anywhere. Continuing improvements of old products and a constant search for new ones typifies the tireless effort required of any successful firm. Progress, and in architecture, the most significant contribution to the housing of business since the skyscraper.
The S.C. Johnson Research Tower, designed by Frank Lloyd Wright, was a beacon of architectural design and product innovation. Opened in 1950, the tower stands 153 feet high with 232 stairs that climb 15 stories. The building is one of the tallest structures ever built on the cantilever principle, with the inner core extending 54 feet into the ground that provides support for the 16 million pound structure. In 2013, the research tower underwent an extensive restoration which involved both the exterior and interior spaces, including the restoration of the tower's 21,170 bricks. More than 7,000 curved Pyrex glass tubes that were used as windows were also replaced. Today, the research tower stands as a magnificent symbol to an historic era of creative and scientific development and bold American ingenuity.
Research indicates 95% of all households in America owns at least one of our products.
Almost every American household?
Yes,
actually.
Yeah. I know we have a lot of people that come in and they'll see our display case. Oh, I didn't know Johnson had that. So yeah, there's a lot of products that people don't know that we manufacture that are out there.
And I love how he built a company, but it was basically like a vision of the future.
Yes.
This concept of tomorrow is coming through.
Yes.
We're in now. Like, that was so forward thinking.
Yes, well, HF did not like the common. He liked things that were different. He also liked to hire local talent, which worked out well for Mr. Wright. When they were doing the administration building, they had actually signed with another firm and they had broken ground. And one day HF said, stop, stop, this is not the building I want. And that's, after that, he was fortunate enough to connect with Mr. Wright, and the rest is history.
And you know, today, it's wonderful that we still have these buildings. Is mm-hmm. it an interesting point in Racine? Like, would this have been demolished at one point?
This would never be demolished because both the administration building and the research tower were designated as historical landmarks in 1976. In 1986, the American Institute of Architects named both buildings to be among the top 10 examples of successful architectural design, and the administration building is also celebrated as being one of the top 25 buildings of the 20th century.
That's great. Also, to have this as the place of invention, the factories themselves, would they be nearby, or would
our main manufacturing facility was built out about 7 miles west of here. It opened in 1955. When it opened, it covered 157,000 square feet. Today it covers 2.2 million square feet. And that is our main manufacturing facility. If you came in on Highway 20 or Washington Avenue and saw the two large wind turbines, that's our Waxtell manufacturing facility.
So we still manufacture Johnson products today?
That they ship out over 1 million pallet loads of completed goods from that factory annually.